the legs. Okay. Hold the hands. Bring up. Down. Good. And keep that going. Okay. It takes my work. Keep it going. Thank you. My name is Odugbo Moses. I hold a fifth degree black belt in karate. And, I teach mostly in schools. There are some of the schools that I'm still working with today that I started as far back as 1990. So I can proudly say that in the over 3 decades of coaching, I handle both children and adults. I went into martial arts basically to learn to defend myself. And, I was quite young when I started. I have a very close friend who's like a brother to me. He actually started doing karate. I remember going with him, standing around to watch him, you know, when they were training too. So I got inspired. And, he encouraged me as name as well. His name is Shihan Ejim Oga. He holds a 7th degree black belt in karate. Since then, I grew up, trained myself, developed myself in different areas. I became a coach. Incidentally, both of us became like business partners. Right? Till date, we're still working together in some of my schools. Well, what we do basically is that a lot of children, most of them are aggressive in nature. But each school that I go to introduce karate, I tell them that karate is an art of self-defense. And it's not just learning to kick and punch. Before we begin to use it as a sporting stuff, there is the traditional aspect of karate which comes with a lot of discipline. And so we have discipline like respect to others. And we tell them that, look, when you learn karate, it is not for you to use it to bully other children. It is not for you to use it to beat up other children. Okay? It's an art of discipline, and when you go into it, you're going to use it in maybe a situation where you know you can't come out alive. You get attacked, you get mocked. When you can use it to defend yourself, you have a little break, you can run for run as fast as you can and call for help. And that's why we tell them that as small as they are, we start training them from children from 4 years and above. And so we start to build this up in them. And as they grow up, it's like that. We tell them, if we get any report that you have fought with anybody, you kick anyone in your class, you fight with your siblings at home, we're going to throw you out of karate for good. Because that is not what karate is about. And some of them are bold enough to ask you, coach, you said I should not use it to fight. Why then am I doing karate? I tell them, well, we'll teach you karate so that you can use it to defend yourself when it is necessary. Okay? But the first thing you learn to take away from karate is that discipline, self-respect, and respect to others too. Well, you know, I have a lot of schools where I coach karate. I have schools in Lekki, Kohi, Victoria Land, Ogudu, GRA, Magodo, GRA. And I also have instructors who are working with me under my payroll. And so I pay them as well to go with me different schools to train. And then when the pandemic broke out in March last year, and there was this lockdown. There was virtually nothing for us to do. Even some of those instructors were like, all over me. Coach, what are we going to do? No school, no this. I said, okay, just manage. And you know, when this thing happened, it was unexpected. And it started like a joke. At first, you know, we were hoping that, okay, schools will reopen in another 2 weeks, maybe 1 month, 3 months. And it continued until the end of year 2020. And while in lockdown, I noticed a lot of children in my vicinity, around my community, were just playing, roaming around, playing rough tackles, doing all sorts of things. And a thought struck me. I said, look, instead of just allowing these children to go around like that, and now you have all the time, why don't you bring them together and then try and impact some of them around the community, give back to what you know, others gave to me. And God will have it, my little daughter was already training, she has already been competing. And in one of recent programs, like I do organize inter-school karate championships, bring all my schools together once every year, December. And so in December of 2019, I took my daughter and my landlord's granddaughter to such competitions, and they both came out with gold medals. So I had to first of all use my daughter, my landlord's granddaughter, brought them together. I was teaching them at home. And so I invited these other kids too, who started joining us. And as others were seeing us, they too became interested. We started like maybe from 3 to 4, 5 to 6. Now I have about 13 children, you know, and I train them for free. The only thing is that when you do karate and you want to be fully involved, feel like you're part of it, then you have to have the costume, the uniform. And that was when I tried to invite some of the parents to tell them, look, the children are interested. I organized a display. The children performed before their parents. The parents were, you know, very, very encouraged. And I told them, look, assist these children. Let's see how we can, you know, buy the uniform for them. I gave them from when we just started around March, I gave them till September to come up with half of the money that is charged for the uniform that I could make it. But funny enough, not a single person was able to come up with anything. And so when schools reopened in September or thereabout, I said, okay, the waiver, you know, this thing was over, that whoever want to buy a uniform, it will have to be full amount. Okay, I charge them according to what my designers will charge. Up till now, well, in a short while you begin to see some of them be around, so we can train. And then you see that apart from my daughter, who has had this uniform, the rest of them will be training without the uniform because the parents cannot afford it. So I've just been taking them like that. So the only regret is that even if things return to normal, and I would love to really take them out to compete, you know, expose them to trainings and competitions all around Lagos. And there's no way you can take them there without the uniform. That is why I've been pleading with the children to try. So far there's no money, and I can't blame them because I know things are tough for everybody. So that didn't discourage me. I'm just training them like that. Depending when God will maybe give us the opportunity.
Jordan Zuki! Yeah! testimony, and I've been learning karate about 1 year and a half, and I liked it and everything. It was good, and I loved it.
My name is Ogulanoye Wande, and I've been learning karate for over 2 years. It's fun, and somehow I've gone for a competition before, and I won gold medal and a yellow belt.
What have you learned in the past 2 years? You've learned
to fence.
So, for instance, I owed you here. How are you supposed to respond?
My name is Solomon Wisdom. I'm 14. Like, I've been doing karate for, let me say, over a year now. I've been learning karate for over a year. So. And I think karate is great. It's fun, it's cool. It has helped me a lot, even at school. Now, I don't think I could be bullied anymore. And karate has, like, I have a lot of benefits in karate. I have good self-confidence. Now, I'm sure in myself, I'm confident in myself. And it has increased, it has boosted my fitness. And also, now, I think I'm disciplined. Now, even around, like, sometimes you want to do some kicks. Before it was so hard, but now I think I'm great and it's cool. I'd say a big, like, words cannot address the type of thank you I want to tell him, but I just want to tell him a big thank you.
My name is Yusuf Bamiosola. I'm learning karate for more than a year now. It started, it was hard. I wanted to quit, but I just had to keep moving on. So, but now it's no more hard, it's like usual stuff. So, benefit of karate, I've been doing karate now, it has given me self-confidence. And it has given me self-confidence, like, and it has given me fitness. Like, sometimes I would just be walking, my leg would just be, but now, things like that just stress me. I would like to tell him thank you so much, and God will be blessed.
Are you ready for pump kick? Are you ready? Yeah. Sir, please call the shots as it's Zeus. Let's go.
Okay, ready? You lock your knee when you kick, okay? If I catch your leg looking like this, I'll break your knee. You stretch it, all right? Make sure you're not. Go, everybody!
Alright, thank you guys. See you. Watch out for. Thank you so much, huh? For me, Abby.
Show me.
Right? Thank you! Mama, don't play with me!